Alright, I'm going to demonstrate to you how to construct a simple ID light circuit, alright, for your project. Alright, first of all, you need to have the following materials ready for your project before you go about doing your soldering. Alright, what we're going to see here, we have is your, this is called your wire stripper. Alright, it's basically to remove the insulation of the wire. Over here we have is a core of the solder, right? So it's basically help to join the components together, right, by fusing the solder to the joint. And over here we have two pieces of wire, one's a black wire, one's a red wire. Basically the black wire represents the negative path of the circuit, and red is normally used to represent the positive path, alright? So later I'm going to explain how to use the wire stripper to remove the wire, okay? Next, we have the LED component. It's the light device, right, to provide lighting. And also, we have a simple push switch. All right, it's a simple switch whereby you have a button there, and you basically press down to activate the on of the light, and you press again to deactivate the off to the circuit. All right, and we have a nut to secure the switch. And over here, this is the battery holder for the 1.5 volt. So basically we need two pieces of 1.5, I believe it's the double A battery, which should be used to provide the power supply. Okay, first of all, we have over here a soldering iron, which is going to use for soldering the circuit together. And this is a soldering stand. Alright, okay, this is the heating element, okay, which is very hot. Okay, do not touch this part. Instead, you should hold at the handle of the soldering iron. After use, just make sure you return the soldering iron back onto the soldering stand, such that you know it's safe and will not burn the equipment or the yourself. Over here, there's a moist sponge. Okay, it's used to clean the tip of the soldering iron, alright, such that it becomes a shiny surface. Because after using, alright, it may have some impurities stuck there, and it'll be very difficult to do the soldering. Alright, so just put back. Okay, over here we have a long nose plier. It's used to bend wires or also sometimes to bend the component pin. The materials used for doing the soldering circuit, okay, we have here is a solder, alright. We have here which is a wire. We have this is a push switch together the nut. This is the LED, stand for light emitting diode, which consists of two pins. One pin is the positive, the longer leg, and the shorter leg is the negative pin, right? Over here we have a simple 3-volt supply battery holder with a red and black wire which shows the positive as well as the negative path. Okay, the first thing you need to do is to take the circuit top cover, right, and you place the push switch in this way through the slot. Right, and you insert the nut through. Alright, you have this nut. Make sure there's the teeth. Alright, the teeth is supposed to be pointing outwards. Alright. Alright, you slowly tighten the nut all the way to the end. Alright, showing the grip of the teeth touching the PVC casing. Alright? Yep. Okay, so it doesn't move. Yeah, that's how it looks. Right over here, we notice the pin actually is sticking slightly outside of the switch. And what you have to do is to bend it 90 degrees downwards. All right, so you know, such that it doesn't touch the bottom casing. Okay, how you're gonna do it is use the grip of the long nose plier. Okay, hold near to the end and just bend downwards. Okay, you can use it to turn it around, it'll be easier. Bend it down this way. Okay, like this, 90 degrees. Next we do is top. Okay, screw it slightly. Front, span downwards. Okay, like this, 90 degrees. Alright, next we're going to remove the insulation of the red wire that you've given, just by putting the grip through about 1 cm, slightly through the grip, and just press the handle and just slide out the exposed copper. Alright, red wire to the same opposite side. Okay, about put in about 1 cm spacing, then afterward through the grip, then just press the handle. Like this. Let's say the strand is slightly like, you know, sticking out, you can actually try to straighten them and maybe try to twist to form a single core. Like this. Alright, next you use black wire which is provided. Alright, insert the wire to about 1 cm distance, then just press it down and just press the handle to slide out the insulation. And you can use your fingers to slide out the rubber insulation. Okay, next you do the for the opposite end. Okay. And you and just slide out. Okay. Next you can twist them to form a, like a single wire. Alright, next you notice your LED itself has a longer leg compared to the other pin. And what you're gonna do, you have to use the red wire, alright, and you connect it to the longer pin of the LED. Notice, alright, this is longer, so you can spread the leg slightly out, so make it easier to connect. Alright, place the copper strand somewhere about 1 cm from the end, and just coil around like this. And likewise, do it for the black end of the wire. Okay, hold it about 1 cm from the pin with the finger gripping to the copper strand, coil it around. Okay, so you can see this is how it looks. Make use of masking tape, alright, to help you to secure the LED to your table so that the pin doesn't move when you do the soldering. Likewise, heat the joint first and apply the solder across like this. Okay, and likewise do it for the same, heat the joint first and let the solder apply the spring across like this. And this is how you connect the LED to the wires. The next thing we'll do, alright, is to take the wire. Alright, you have this battery holder. Make use of the red wire. Alright, let's say the part here, the exposed copper is like not too exposed. You can use a wire stripper. Right, hold the red wire, slightly insert about 1 cm into the grip. This, and you press the handle, and you slide the insulation out from the wire. And also, you can do it for this part. Just press the handle, slide out. Okay, the next we're gonna insert right this copper through the slot. This okay, just insert halfway, and what you're gonna do is a bend copper backwards. Okay, and you twist them form a loop. Alright. Now heat up the joint, the wire. Okay, first of all, heat up the joint first and apply solder to it. Okay, about 2 to 3 seconds and it fills the joint. Okay, and you can test it out to see whether it comes up. No? Alright, that means it's good joint. Next you can join like this both the black wire to the black wire end of the battery holder like this, so it doesn't come out easily. And same thing, you have to join first and apply solder to it by spreading it across like this. form a nice clean joint. Alright, next, insert the LED through the slot for the casing, like this. Try to stretch the wire as much as possible and place battery this way. Right, and you may want to twist the wire so that it come neater to organize the wires into the box. Okay, after you have finished putting in the battery, right, which is the AA battery into your battery holder, alright, ready to test the circuit. Okay, how you test is just to depress the button one time, alright, to on it, and press again to off it. Okay, next I'm going to show you how to place the battery onto the casing. So make sure the wires that is sticking out from the battery holder is facing towards the wall. The inner wall that shows the bent part, right, like this. Okay, and twist the wire this way, this so that 90 stay thick, the out again, cross this and just like together this thing to cover one. All right, next we're gonna use the Velcro. You see it's right. Then we have the one that is the soft part and the part that have the sticky part. Alright, so the sticky part is all going to be placed over here. Right, we have the sticky tape, stick it here. And place it here, somewhere in the middle, like this. Right, and you can test it again.